Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install SQLite DB browser in industrial operating system. So let's begin. Now to install SQLite DB browser, you need to just simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar you need to just simply type SQLite DB browser download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing the first search result is SQLite browser. So just you know, simply click on this downloads DB browser for SQLite, and this will now going to redirect you to this official site of SQLite DB browser. In here, if you just simply scroll down a bit under these windows, you'll be getting this DB browser for SQLite standard installer for 64-bit Windows. Since I am using 64-bit operating system, so what I'll be doing is I'll be simply proceed with this download link, right? So if you are using some other operating system, let's say Mac OS or Linux or any other operating system, then you need to just simply proceed with those links. Since I have already downloaded it, I just simply you can clearly see it has rightly started downloading and also been completed. So now just simply cancel it, and if I just simply minimize my browser and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this DB browser SQLite 3.12.2 has been rightly downloaded over here, and the file size you can clearly see is just 17.2 MB. right, now to install SQLite DB browser, you need to just simply double click on it, and let us first minimize our download directory so you can clearly see our DB browser SQLite setup wizard has been rightly opened. In here you need to just simply click on next. Then you need to just simply accept this license agreement. If you have time, you can always read that, right? And then you need to just simply click on next. And then under the shortcut, it is asking which are the options you'd like to choose. I'd like to check desktop and program menu for DB browser SQLite, right? I don't want SQL cipher now, so I just simply skip that. I'll just only check this desktop and program menu for SQLite, and then just simply click on next. And this is going to be our installation location, so if you want to change that, you can always click on browse and you can do that, but I'm going to keep everything as default, and then just simply click on next. And now it's saying that it's ready to be installed, so just simply click on install for installation, and you can clearly see our installation for DB browser for SQLite has been rightly began. So this installation might take a couple of minutes. So what I will be doing is I'll be coming back after installing SQLite DB browser. Yeah. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see our SQLite DB browser has been rightly installed. So just simply click on finish. And now you can clearly see our DB browser shortcut has also been created over here. To fire up our DB browser, so just simply double click on it. And this is going to launch our SQLite DB browser, and you can clearly see our DB browser for SQLite has been rightly launched over here. In here, I'm going to show you how to create database, then how to create table, right? So for that, stay connected with this video, right? And so what I'll be doing is I'll be first creating a new database. So for that, just simply click on new database, and this is going to open this window. So it is basically asking under which file name you want to save this. So I'm just simply go to documents, and then I'll just simply give a database name as test, let's say, right? And then just simply click on save, and you can clearly see our test DB has been created and is currently asking to create a table. So let's give a table name as users, right? And let's add some field over here. So for that, just simply click on add, and let's give the first field as ID, and the type is integer is fine. Then check this, not null, then primary key, then auto increment, right? And you can also check unique, right? So do check that, and let's add one more column. So let's give the column name as name, basically, right? And let's change its type to text, and let's keep everything other as default. You don't need to check that, right? And you can clearly see this snippet SQL code snippet has also been generated over here. Now all you need to do is you need to just simply click on OK. And you can clearly see this SQL, basically this users table has been right recreated with our ID as a primary key. Right. Now let's say you want to, you know, enter some data. So for that, you need to just simply click on browse data. And now under this table, you need to choose a table. So let's choose our table users. And you can clearly see this two field ID and name has been in a directory, you know, shown over here. So let's give the ID as 1 and let's give the name as, let's say, Shoulder. Expand this, you know, so that it is gets properly visible. So Shoulder. Right. Let's insert one more data. So for that, you need to just, you know, simply click on this icon and you can, you know, simply proceed with another new data. So let's give the ID as 2 this time and let's give the name as Rahul. Right. Let's add one more data. So ID is 3 and let's give the name as, let's say, Gautam. Right. So in this way, you can easily install DB browser for SQLite in Windows 10 operating system. Right, I have rightly shown you how to install DB browser, and then I have also shown you how to create database and how to insert data in our table. Right, so that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and should do share with your